Hello, Doom RL fans and roguelike fans and people who are just wondering what I'm doing right now. I'm doing a thing with Doom the Roguelike, or as it's now known, DRL. Thanks, Bethesda. Because apparently they sent a cease and desist over to Kornel as they were in the middle of the Jupiter Hell Kickstarter, which I am looking forward to. I am not involved in the least. I just really like Doom the Roguelike, or DRL, I guess we would call it now. And I'm really looking forward to Jupiter Hell, and I thought, well, do what I can to raise awareness of the thing that exists, because I don't know if everyone knows that it exists, but it looks really cool. And if it's anything like Doom RL, which apparently it will be really cool. Anyway, I'm just going to go through myself with my standard build, which is the Gun Kata build. And whatever. So, for those of you not familiar, Doom the Roguelike is a roguelike based on Doom, classic first-person shooter. It shouldn't be too surprising because that is the name, or was the name. Anyway, this, as not surprising, is basically, give me that. Took my med pack. All right, but yeah, this is the opening level, basically standard setup of you. Opens up killing zombies, as it does. And we'll, of course, move beyond the next. There should be a Sergeant Shotgun Wielder in here somewhere. It's not quite as complex as the first level of the original Doom. This actually isn't as, like, most roguelikes, they are procedurally generated. That's one of the big parts of roguelikes. And Doom RL is, by and large, no exception. But the first level, as well as any level you access through a red staircase, which will come up later, are not as procedurally generated. Like, they're still kind of procedurally generated. But I guess, yeah, the only way to describe it is they're not as procedurally generated. Ow, darn you. Anyway, so there's about four or five layouts for this area. Yeah, this is... Now we're going into the actual constructed thing. So the Gun Kata build, which is what I'm doing now, based on pistols, based primarily on getting two pistols. Ow. Well, starting out with getting the Son of a Gun trait, which increases the damage you deal. Increases the damage you deal from using pistols. And then eventually you get two pistols. And the dual gunner trait that allows you to actually wield two pistols like you're coming out of equilibrium. And finally, you end up running a lot with a hell runner, which increases your movement speed. And very end of it, you get the Gun Kata trait, which lets you reload after killing. Which is particularly useful if you get one of the higher capacity pistols that gives you a lot of fire, a lot of ammo to work with without having to reload. I forgot to run. The thing about this build is that you actually have to run a lot. Like, running is super important. There we go. Running is super important because, I mean, unless I were to show up a shotgun from time to time in order to be able to actually hit things in the dark without having to aim. I have no easy way of... Darn it. I have no easy way of getting to the point of actually hitting things without being... Ow. Should have dodged first. I can't easily hit things without risking getting hit myself. What? Oh. Right, I don't have Dodge Master yet. Oops. Darn it. Well, there's a health glow, so I can get my run back. So yeah, the health globes give you health, they give you your running back. Whenever you run, you are basically... You're vulnerable until... Where are you? You're vulnerable once you're done until you take a health pack. Either heal up or get to the next level. And I'm not planning to get to the next level before I kill everything, thus healing up is kind of the only way. Yeah, it's a shell box. Whatever. I really only like to use shotguns to open up boxes, which they are very useful for. So yeah, my option here, Hell's Arena, which is possibly death if I'm not careful, because it is Hell's Arena. What do I have inventory-wise? 2 med bags. Am I missing anything? There's a lever, which I doubt will help me much. There's not much I need. Maybe armor regeneration is about the only thing I can think of. I don't believe I got a tracking map, so, or a computer map in this level. Oh, it's level 2. I did get a computer map, so no, there's nothing else. But Hell's Arena would be super risky. And let's go for it. If it doesn't work out, then I'll just do things the safer way next time. But the experience... Alright, that's one. Pretty much have to use this. There's really no way to safely get through Hell's Arena without using a shotgun. Especially when you have to deal with that crap. But yeah, Hell's Arena I don't like to go to unless I have like 5 med packs. Because it means less running, and it means obviously fewer mistakes can be made. How many shotgun shells do I have? 111. Okay, we're good. As long as I switch to pistol to actually get kills, should be fine. Oh, there you are. Eesh. Nope, I gotta heal up. Darn it. This is what I mean. I was hoping to avoid that, but I don't have reloader, so shotgun's pretty much impossible to really use well. Ah, phew. You pass by me, then kill you. No, I don't want to risk getting one shot by things. Also means I can't go past this round without potentially dying. Oh, no. Nope. Come on. Darn it! How did you hit me? Shit. No, this is not going to work. That was a mistake. Alright, Hell's Arena. This is what I mean. I need like 5 med packs to get in, and that's basically if I get all the med packs, then I'm okay. And I didn't get any med packs, and now I'm kind of hooped because I didn't get to the second stage. Well, that's my funeral. Well, it occurred to me I forgot to actually get that. Oh, good. Thank goodness I found armor. I got plenty of pistol ammo, at least. That won't be a problem. This is gonna involve a lot of super safe radar shooting. Despite the fact that it's not- I mean, I find with this build, I don't really want to switch exclusively to pistols until I get to dual gunner. Like, then the damage output is high enough that it's worth it. But if I find any time before that, it's just too risky to really do compared to the damage output of just using a shotgun. Because shotguns are broken. Unless I get lucky like this and get vision in advance. It's just awesome. Thank you for the vision. Thank you for dying. Oh, crap. Nah, there's no easy way. Okay. Aha! Son of Gun 3! Actually, I'd say this is about the point where I prefer to go for pure pistol. Because I'm dealing enough damage to basically two-shot any enemy weaker than a pinky. And next level is dual gunner, where I'll be able to two-shot every... Oh, no, I don't want to do that. Crap. Okay. Come at me. Bro! And then... Crap! I don't want to. Nope. I think this will be enough to kill the Pinky in time. Oh, good. Ow. If I had waited 2 seconds, I would have seen that there was a health globe there, and I could have saved the health pack. Alright, whatever. Mistake on my part, but that'll be fine. Because tracking maps... the last enemy in the level. Yay. Oh, seriously, there's all these health globes. I just got unlucky as to where I went first. I might as well grab them, I guess. No, grab you and run so I can maintain this health as long as possible. Yeah, there's not much here. Woo, I have spare armor. Alright. Okay, that's bad. Run! Oh, are you coming? I said... Shit. Well, at least I had the extra health to work with. Hooray for health buffers. But yeah, because it's 2d4... Basically, my damage right now is 2d4 plus 3, so it's anywhere from 5 to 11. Once I get Dual Gunner, it'll be anywhere from 10 to 22. And then it's awesome. Also, I should make sure this is loaded. Okay, good. Shotgun's loaded, just in case we get another one of those close call situations where I have a Pinky on me and I don't want to die. No. Okay, anything else? I have no easy way of running from here. There's nothing I can refresh my run with. Eat! Kornel shooting for the win! Oh. Hey! Hooray! You walked into a death trap. Because you can't do anything when you're not that... when you're too far away from me to actually do anything. Alright. Get close enough to you that I can actually hit you. Yeah, I'll save that for when I'm done with the... You've got to be kidding me. Is this seriously running the entire... This is run... it's one of these levels. Well, I got a supercharged globe. Run! Ow. I'd say that was worth it. I'd like to kill all the enemies that spawn. There's a reward for that if I manage to actually win. So I'm gonna actually get up to the point where I'm close enough to win. Okay, so close to that precious dual gunner. Well, just to kill all the enemies. Also, I get more experience, I get dual gunner faster, I get all the things I need faster. I'm not going to get Gun Kata until halfway through Deimos anyway. It's halfway through, because for those of you who are not familiar with the game is split up into three parts, and apparently this will also be true with Jupiter Hell, which is, I think I mentioned why I'm doing this, because I want, despite the fact that I'm not involved with Kornel at all, it's like, or with ChaosForge, it's like, I just want Jupiter Hell to exist. It looks like it'll be a super cool game, and it's supposed to be like mRL. And... I mean, it's like a mix of mRL and another game called Aliens RL, which is essentially what it sounds like, except more survival horror as roguelike, rather than this, which is just action shooter as roguelike. But yeah, with Aliens RL, it's more you have these towers, and you have to move between the towers, and that gets you more stuff. With mRL, it's more that you have... You basically just go level by level by level. And unlike most roguelikes, you can't go back up, you just go straight down, that's the only way you can go. Jupiter Hell apparently is going to be a mix of the two. Yeah, I was afraid that would happen. Well, I should actually use the fire mode when I'm trying to figure out... if I'm aiming around barrels. There you are. 59% of the way to the next level. What? No. Wrong button. Ow. Large med pack. Precious large med pack. Oh, are you gonna come at me? Well, you're gonna die anyway. Ow. That was a nice roll. That was a higher roll. All the formers have 10 HP. So that was on the higher end of rolls. Okay, I just need health globe. Please let there be a health globe around here somewhere. I don't know if I want to go in there. That's going to be full of demons. That's a box of demons. That's always a box of demons. I don't have any way of running right now. Ow! Okay, so... best case scenario is I find another large health globe, actually, would be the best case scenario. If I can find a large health globe, I won't have to use my large med pack. Oops. Get rid of you. But yeah, so... apparently Jupiter Hell is going to be a mix of the two, where you have... you have kind of level by level, but it's literally... you have the horizontal tower setup of Aliens RL, but you then go from tower complex to tower complex in the same way you go between Phobos, Deimos, and Hell in Doom RL. There's two of these? There's two monster closets. That actually is a first for me in this game. All right, fine. That was bad. Let's try that again. I'll do better this time. Can't believe I died. I mean, granted, that was not a great situation, but like, I should have just not gone. I think the arena was the real mistake, because I didn't have the opportunity to go from there to anywhere else. The other med pack. Oh, someone's got to be hanging out around here, aren't they? That's actually kind of unusual. Normally, I don't die that early. Normally, I died somewhere in, like, middle of Deimos in this build, but... like I said, normally I also don't go into Hell's Arena. Ah, there you are. I realize I used all this time to get a bunch of med packs that I still very nearly died for. But, irony aside. Alright, whatever. Usually there's enough in the next level I can work with for everything else. Not a big deal. Like health globes and such. Go the safe way for now. The shotgun. Not really logged into my build yet, so... oh! Armor! Armor, armor, armor! Also pinky. I need that armor. Alright. Oh, that just hit my armor. Didn't actually hurt me. That was lucky. Please just die so I can get to this health globe. Haha! My plan worked! You're too stupid to know that barrels explode! And now you'll never know. And that's another med pack. I realize it doesn't mean I'm good if I'm not using them, but... Hey, I can actually do the arena this time. What, six med packs? That's actually more than most. I never get that many. Five is usually, like, awesome. Not sure what to do about six. All right, let's see how this goes. Ow. Mind you, I did make a point of getting the two med packs in the opening level, and a lot of the time, you can lose out on those because... Oh, another one? Oh, I see. Well, you know, I'm just gonna use this one. Because at this point, I don't seem to be finding any health globes. That was a mistake. I started running and then I didn't stop and oh, great. Alright, please tell me there are health globes around here so I don't have to use this med pack in order to not die in the arena. Seems like I'm still going to have five med packs going into the Hell's Arena. So, assuming I do go into it. I mean, the reward is a rocket launcher and a much harder chained court. I'm not sure if... I mean, the Archvile staff is pretty nice. I'll try it one more time. Oops. I really preferred the layout I had last time. Alright. Ow! Darn it! I actually haven't done Hell's Arena in my recent runs all that often. And honestly, with a pistol build, it's not that easy. With any build, it's not that easy, because you're basically not in a position where you're actually able to... Crying out loud. Okay, forget the pistol. Shotgun and shotgun alone. That's the only real option that works here. Pistol has not enough damage to make anything work. Shotgun at least is knockback. Bloody pinky stay out of my bloody hair. Bloody with their blood. Oh, darn it! Yeah, why not? I think I've learned what I need to do to approach this, and I have 14 shotgun. Oh, crap. Well, I can't radar shoot then. Oh. Thank goodness. Where are you, demon? Of course. All right. Ah, dodging worked. Hey, my dodging worked. Okay, that's another Cacodemon down. I don't know if there was lost souls in here somewhere. And no, I'm not going to go for stage 3. Ow! Darn it, why did I walk into them? That was... No. I want my med packs back. That's the only reason I went to stage 3. Was to gamble on maybe getting back... Oh, what am I doing? Get the shells. Gamble on the med packs. And that was it. That's all I cared about, getting my resources at least somewhat replenished. which barely even happened. Wow, this is going very poorly. Maybe I should not bother with Hell's Arena in the future. Full health and med pack. Berserk pack, rather. And we'll talk about dangerous. Bad idea. Bad move. What the? Stop! I was trying to avoid that exact situation. Darn it. Why is this working out so poorly for me? Like, I'm not kidding. I normally don't have trouble with getting to anywhere past... Anywhere past the opening. There's a reason I stopped doing Hell's Arena. It's pointless. Hey. Alright, let's just not do Hell's Arena this time, no matter how many med packs I get. If I get a bunch of med packs, awesome. Otherwise, don't bother. Man, I didn't expect to be... I feel stupid about those stupid barrels. I could have easily handled that. Alright. I'm not gonna blame luck for that. That's a manageable situation. Oh, come on! Yeah, there's a perfectly manageable situation I failed to manage. That was my bad. It was definitely a tough situation, I'll grant that. But I was actually managing it, and then I just stopped. And then died. Alright, son of a gun too. I will get to Dual Gunner! Some point. Like, everything becomes so much easier once you get Dual Gunner and I can one-shot most of these fools. Oh wait, what am I doing? Another one of those monster closets. I think it's a monster closet full of lost souls. No, it's nothing. Hey, a combat shotgun. Nice. I mean, while I'm still working out the kinks from the build, because as mentioned before, this is not when the build is actually useful. Not yet. It will be useful soon. It'll just be useful in, like, two more levels. Quit tempting me, game. I mean, I have 91 shotgun shells, too. Like, it gets me a level a bit sooner. I have the med packs. I have a combat shotgun. I've got basically everything I would like in order to not die doing this stuff. Uh-huh. Okay. Ow. Well, that wasn't bad. That's most of the enemies in the first wave already gone. With a combat shotgun, I can generally kill everything and have 100 shells or had 100 shells upon entering. And that's Son of a Gun 3, alright. Yes. Get another med pack going. Dodge. Ah! Kelkos. Not helping. Why'd I take that risk? Stupid alcove. Should have known better. I mean, I know better, I just didn't think better. That was the problem. Those alcoves are death when you're trying to play a dodging strategy, which you generally are since getting hit. And DMRL is not exactly something you can easily recover from, which is one of the unique things about DMRL, I find. DMRL and Aliens RL both. Aliens RL pushes that concept even further because you don't have... You basically don't have anything as a backup. Ah... No... Just screwed up again. Let's get a large med kit, but somewhere. You just get a lot more resources if you actually win the last battle. Alright, whatever. So, once again, Hell's Arena, disappointing as always. Oh, I had another med pack. I don't think I could have done it. I mean, you get med packs for going to stage 2, like, you get it both for avoiding stage 2 and entering stage 2. I swear I'll go back to bullets once I'm done getting the dual... Once I get the dual gunner trait, then I can use the guns and it'll actually be... Or the pistols, rather. And it'll actually be all worth it. Actually, I could use it here, too. No, that's gonna blow stuff up. Okay, well, you're dead. Stupid former sergeants. Those are the worst. Like, it's actually, honestly, a bit of a design fail with this game, which is unfortunate. I don't want to really bring that up, but it's like, it's one thing I don't like about this game is former sergeants. And it's actually one of the reasons I run into everything rather than walk. Is because if you're running, you can often get the drop on enemies. Oh, nice. Nice! Wait, no room in inventory. Oh, sheesh. But yeah, shotgunners, they just hit you and you can't do anything about it. Unless you get the drop on them. That's the only option you have. Why are there so many computer maps? Yeah, I should probably heal up. Alright. Man, I don't need this. Two blue armors! Actually, I guess I kinda do, because it increases my move speed. Yeah, move speed 1 second per move. Normally be higher, but scouts have increased move speed anyway. My move speed's down to normal. I'm like all the normal people. I don't have my super fast move speed. Hey, boots. Do those affect my move speed? They do not. Because I could have checked the equipment screen too, but whatever. Hey, you can't be that dangerous. Hey, I healed up. Nice. Oh. Alright. I can deal with that. Oh. Oh! Get you. Ammo chain. Okay, nice thing about combat shotgun, you reload, well, you, not so much reload, but you pump by moving. Which is super handy. Like, it is a life saver. Actually, why am I using the regular shotgun? But yeah, it's super handy to have the move while shooting thing. Okay, bulk mod pack. I want to mod one of you. So I have more ammo. What I'd like to do is to have the offhand pistol be the one that has more ammo. And then the main hand pistol be one that has... Oh, what does agility pack do again? Agility pack was reload speed? Oh, weapon accuracy. Hmm. Not a bad idea. Usually like a technical mod pack to reduce reload time. But yeah, so the idea being that the offhand pistol is going to get reloaded less, but it might be able to do single reloads. Because reload speed is the killer for a dual gunner build of any variety. And I mean, that's basically what Gun Kata does. It gets rid of that problem. Sort of, if you can kill within a clip. And it depends on how big your pistols are. Combat pistols are a godsend in this build, because then you end up getting a massive clip size. Oh boy. That's not a great start. But yeah, combat pistols are the best thing in the world. But I don't have one yet. If I find one, that'll be awesome, because they have a 15 ammo clip. Now, what am I doing? Combat pistols have a 15 ammo clip, so I end up just being able to kill... Aha! Dual gunner! There we go. Oops, what? No. Oh, darn it. No. I want to equip the pistol. There we go. This is what I mean. But the problem is that reloading is... Dual reloading is a lot slower than single reloading. So I prefer to dual reload only when I know I'm safe. Which is why I like to have bulk mods, so I get a couple extra shots. And I can just reload one gun and spend less time reloading. Okay, so that's chain cord. It's gonna be the easy chain cord. We did not beat Hell's Arena. Where'd you go off to? Ah. Kill that one. and that one, and that one, and that. Oops. Yeah, no, there's no way to kill that one. But that's where Dual Gunner comes in. I click on them and they die, assuming they both hit. But assuming they both hit, click and dead. I don't have enough room for a phase device. Always have enough room for a phase device. Phase devices are teleporters. I never not have enough room for a teleporter. Not so much ammo. Should probably get a bit more shotgun shells just to be safe. You never know when you're gonna need shotgun shells, either to blow away a bunch of enemies, or just because you're dealing with things like lost souls, which are harder to get rid of normally. Alright. Die, you. There we go. This is working a lot better than last time. I think we're good. Hell's Arena was a bit of a misadventure, but now everything seems to be coming up. Me! And chain court should be trivial. This is the easy chain court, so meh. To the point that I prefer to come out here, kill all the non-Hell Knight monsters. Then kill the Hell Knights. Because they're a bit of a pain, yes, but I just find it a lot easier to not have to worry about it. There we go. Alright, that's the left side down. Ah. There we go. The left side down, right side, soon be down. Darn it, you could have knocked me to lava there. I want to change my armor. Blue and red armor, as it gets that little slash two, it gets reduced as you get your health, your armor integrity gets reduced. A little percentage there. I don't want to hold on to damaged armor if I don't have to. Alright, there we go. That's everything that I can hit. Now for the chainsaws. What? Oh, what? Ah! Yeah! I'll cut you! Cut, 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 cut! Well, saw, I guess. Yeah, I mean, the way you're supposed to go through it is grab the chainsaw, saw off a bunch of things, then grab other stuff and saw off a bunch of other things. And I mean, it's not a bad idea. Oops. Wrong weapon. Ow. That's not everything yet. If I use this on my weapon, do I get something? No, I can't. I think this increases armor move speed, but this armor is so close to just being thrown out. Okay, there we go. It's bulk mod. Actually, wait, no, I don't know what I'll do. Use this on my boots. Oh, wow. Oh, right, I'm berserk. Never mind, that's why. Berserk increases your move speed as well, but yeah. Steel boots, plus 10 move speed. Yeah! Bulk mod pack for armor just increases the amount of... Because that integrity value, that is the number of shots you can... Or the number of the damage reduction value. That is exactly what it is. So if you take... If you would take damage, it's reduced by that value. But with bulk mod pack, that integrity value increases... However, oh no, increases armor durability. What am I thinking of? Is it power mod that increases the number of? I think it's power mod that does that. Never mind. I might as well use it in my armor then. I got confused. I think it's power mod pack that increases that integrity value. Although bulk mod pack also reduces the movement speed or increases the movement speed penalty. So I think my overall movement speed is slightly faster. A net gain for me. All right. Oh, hey, it's one of you guys. It was one of you guys. Ow. Ow. And that's when I get Hell Runner and I can just move around as quickly as I can shoot. And that's when it really goes off the rails. Or, wait, that's not the word I'm looking for at all. What the heck am I? Whoa, bang, what language am I even speaking here right now? Not English. Or at least not using it in the way that people normally use it. You got lucky you missed one of those. Or got missed by one of those. Light amp goggles. The best thing for me right now. Oh, darn it, I completely missed a trick. With the chainsaw, there's only one thing you can say. But I missed it, so if it ever comes up again, I'll say it. But it's too late now. The moment's gone. Anyway. What does this do again? I don't know why I'm holding onto a bulk mod pack. Well, I don't have anything to really decrease fire time with, so... Oh, wait, no, this is going to be useful for... No. Actually, yes. Ah, right, speed loader pistol. I love having one of these. Although I just removed the agility. Shoot. So reload speed's better, but the accuracy bonus has been removed. That was a mistake. Well, not a huge mistake. Probably won't mean my death, but it wasn't a great idea. Oh, nice. Watch health go. Ooh, lots of health goes. Where are you? I hear Hell Knights. There you are. Ow. All right. There's still more of you? Okay, I had a bunch of other globes to work. Oh, the supercharged globe. Awesome. I might as well grab all of these and then run afterwards. Because I'm not going to be able to get them in time for it to make a difference and really work for me. There's got to be... There's something else here, though. Oh, there you are. Aha. Reload up. Another maze level. I mean, at least this time, I have all the things I need. I have the tools I need. Or the traits, rather, that I need in order to not die. Hey, and invincibility, too. Invulnerability globe. That is a wonderful sight to see. Back to the speed loader pistol. Oh, is that a homing phase device? Yes, it is. Awesome. I think I'll trade that out. Yay. I mean, the thing is, now that I have Hell Runner, my base move speed is low enough that I can often get the drop on things. Another one? I'm not going to need this as much. All right. Hey, military base. How long does invulnerability last again? Like 30 steps or something? No. That answers my question. That long. I don't need to use that if I don't have to. Thank you for getting closer. And the thing is, I might as well kill the really weak ones. Because these ones here, the elites, they take way more damage to kill. I think they have... Like, they'll take... Even if I hit with good rolls, it'll still take me a lot of shots to kill. Where'd it go? Ah, there you are. You shouldn't have moved there. I can shoot faster than you. All right, now I need that cloak. Admittedly, that was most of the elites. But yeah, the elite health is quite high compared to basically everything else. Ah, come on. Nice on the globe. No. Need a speed loaded pistol. Ow. Doubles? That's a super shotgun. Come on, get out here. Ow. Seriously? Darn it. Sure sounded like it. Like it was a dual shotgun. Whatever. It's dead now. What ammo did I use? Holy crap. Alright, whatever. We're through this section. Might as well clear out the boxes. I'll probably need that eventually. I realize enemies could theoretically go up there and get it, but they'd take too long. Oops. I'll scour the area later. Most of the elites are dead, so whatever. This area is going to be a cakewalk from here on out. As long as I don't get too cocky, I should be able to just erase everything as soon as I see it. Oh, the tracking map, I don't even have to look at. I don't even have to have it in my field of vision. I just know it's there. Like so. Yeah, military base I find to be the easier of the two. It can be military base or Phobos Lab. I've almost never gotten Phobos Lab. Which is also, I find, considerably harder. Because you don't have all these former humans that are pretty much just one-shot kills. Let's use a med pack. Seriously? Well, don't even try. Don't even try me. Darn it. Alright, one more Hell Runner. Right now my armor's damaged. And that's all I have is damaged armor. Might as well drop the armor I'm wearing. There's no point. It doesn't help me because there's no... The move speed penalty is higher than really it's worth at this point. Like, that's the problem. Ah. Go. Erase you. Drop this green armor. Pick up this blue armor. That's at least going to make the move speed penalty worth something. And power mod pack. Confirm that it is armor protection. Yes, it does in fact increase armor protection. Remember if this does anything when I use it on a bulk modded... No, I don't want to. That's going to massively reduce the clip size. Okay. I guess I could use it on the armor. No, I'll save it. I'll save it. Because the very last level of Phobos, you get red armor, and I can increase the protection on that. Which is actually right after this. Like, immediately after this whole thing, I'm going to be having to deal with that. So let's just hold on to that for now. Just gonna think about it. Probably double check to gather all the med packs. Maybe a bit of cleanup. Perfect. All right, so let's just go over here. Clean up all these. Ooh, nice. I don't need steel boots. Oh. Yes, although those are agility modded, so... What does it do to my move speed? Doesn't help it, doesn't hurt it. Oh well. Still better boots. If I found another agility mod, I know what to do with them. Actually, I don't usually agility mod my boots. Or mod my boots at all. So that's interesting. Kind of curious what Jupiter Hell have as a modding system. I can't say it's a part of the game that I really care about all that much. So, for me, it's like, one way or the other. I'm not really all that attached to it. Drop this armor. Hey, the med pack was taken. None of the zombies stole it. None of the formers stole it. I mean, okay, right idea. It's hollows, formers, you know. There's zombies. Zombies are zombies. A zombie by any name would be as rotten. Nope. There we go. Speed loader pistol. Okay, well... I think it's mostly demons, but at the same time, I'm pretty sure I wanted to have... whatever. I have enough shotgun shells. Oh. Okay. One of shotgun shell? Oh. There we go. Let's get out of here. Let's go to Deimos. No, go. I don't care about the chain gun. Alright, am I fully prepared? Well. Ready as I'll ever be. Then mod it with power mod, armor, mod it with bulk mod. Oh wait, I can't do both. Oh yeah, nano, oof. I think nanofiber only gives me one. I can't remember when nanofiber works again. No, it doesn't tell me either. Oh, wait, okay. Wait, hang on a sec. No. Nanofiber armor would probably not work. Like, it's indestructible, but it's stuck at one armor. And for red armor, that's not really all that worth it. Okay. Kind of wish I knew offhand what... did do, though. Anyway. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 'Thank you, Cacodemons, for doing my work for me. Nah, I gotta use shotgun here. Man, an Angel of Marksmanship run would be really hard in this one section. Like, the Bruiser Brothers are a bit of a pain, I will grant. But not compared to this. Oh, what? You're still alive? Actually, you know what? No. Did you get hit? Okay, there we go. Now to deal with the Bruiser Brothers. Good pain. Like, not an insurmountable challenge, but a pain. There we are. I got lucky there. Ow. Let's get to that large health globe and then work from there. Okay, good, I got lucky. Not gonna risk it. Where are you? Actually, also, put on the blue armor. Okay. Oh. That. Wow. Well, I got through it at any rate. That was not the most effective way of doing it. But I'm alive. And actually relatively healthy. The only real problem is armor. So onward to Deimos. So if I get to Deimos, that's basically where I'm able to easily get everything else, because I can get Dodge Master pretty quick, and then Gun Kata. Okay, I need to erase you first. That's why I love this build. Hey! Armor things! Nice, I'm gonna write armor as protection! Did you have to use a med pack? What is that? Blue armor. Eh, whatever. Heavily damaged blue armor at that. No thanks. Dead. Oh. Wow, that was the worst possible timing. Running into the acid without the invulnerable, having invulnerable the entire time. And then I choose the time when it goes away to run to the acid. How much damage is this? Ah, still damaged. Ow! What the heck? Great, now we gotta find an acid-free way of getting in there. Hey, agility mod pack, perfect. Boots. My current move speed is 0.63 without running. I'd like to hear that. Up another barrel. I guess it doesn't really do me a whole lot of good if I'm running quickly if I don't use that speed to my advantage. And actually hit things when I get the drop on them. Dead. They're all dead. Actually, I'm almost dead. Let's not be dead. Wow. Hey, move speed is fast as fire speed, just as I said. Alright, once again. Heal my red armor a bit. Hey, Dodge Master! Now I can dodge things perfectly. Well, the first thing. First thing I get that I would get hit by, I dodge automatically. Ow. How's my combat boots looking? And my boots are in good shape. Okay, for some reason I thought the level was done. Okay, what's that? Because now we're in Deimos, I'm not super confident about what these red stairs are. Hell's Armor. Hell Armory, do I have to deal with the Shambler? I mean, it's pretty easy to get through Hell's Armory with a dual gunner build until you get to the Shambler, and then it becomes a pain. I think I'm guaranteed a combat pistol there. Oh, that is a tough call. I mean, Shambler's definitely beatable. I just don't know if I get a lot of med packs down there. Yeah, worth a shot. Be mindful of the arachnotrons as they come up. She'll be down the line here. Just shoot down the corridor blindly, see what happens. Hey, you. You're dead now. How does that feel? Well, I imagine it doesn't feel like anything because you don't exist, so therefore you have no sensory perception whatsoever. Your conscious experience of life has completely ceased. You're welcome. Actually, I don't know that. I mean, that's kind of the true horror of Doom that's never really acknowledged, is that canonically in Doom, Hell exists. And there's no guarantee that the people you kill, like the formers and such that you kill, aren't like just obliviated. For all we know, they just end up going to hell when their zombification has been destroyed. Like when they've been wrecked to the point that they can't do anything. Oh, wait, I can Dodge Master. Which doesn't help against something that uses repeat shots. At all. One thing I should probably switch over to armor set that actually deals with this well. Yeah, I gotta be careful with those. More so than I have been. Okay. Oh, nice. More of these. Chili mud, technical mud. Don't really have any use for them right now. Wow, these things are fast. Well, so much of the achievement for doing this without taking damage. Ah, subtle knife. I was hoping it'd be a combat pistol. Shoot. That was the only reason I came here, too, actually. Wow, I feel silly now. Pick that up. Use this on my armor to increase move speed. So now I'm just about running as I'm walking. Man, I'm almost at loss. I'm not quite at lost soul speed. Lost soul speed, I think, is like 0.33 per second. Or 0.3 seconds per tile. And I'm at 0.54. Alright. Now, screw it, why not? I don't remember if this thing is a splash damage attack. It's wounded. I'm not risking it. There we go. All right. Thought I was gonna die there. Wasn't quite sure, but hey, it worked out. Feel a bit silly that I got took damage though, and lost all my med packs. All right. What's my inventory looking like? Tech mod, bulk mod, homing device. Actually, you know what? There's some assemblies I can make with this, right? TV, fireproof armor. Nah. Actually, wait a sec. What if I use these on the boots? No. Okay. Oh. They get broken? There's supposed to be designs there. There's supposed to be stuff there. Like assemblies and designs and a bunch of other crap. Wow. Well, this is a complete waste then. I mean, I got better armor, so I'll grant that. Ah, okay, there we go. How do I assemble tactical boots? Steel boots plus agility 2. Oh, I could have used another agility mod there. Huh. Well, those steel boots are never coming back, so whatever. No. I feel like bulk and technical are really common, so I'm not going to worry about them. Let's keep going. Just to know for future how to build tactical boots. That's actually the point of Hell's Armory, as far as I'm aware. Like, the biggest point of Hell's Armory is more of a metagame thing of getting more designs for assemblies. Without, you know, just trolling the wiki. How'd you get hit? All right. Red armor shield up. Not you. Or rather, not another one of you. Oh, never mind. You made a mistake of spawning in lava. You make my life miss difficult. This is actually one of the harder runs I've had for this build in a while. Aha! Armor's back up to full. Granted, the last time I had double combat pistol, and that's living the dream for the Gun Kata build. Or any dual gunner build. Oh no, Gun Kata build specifically, not any dual gunner build. For most dual gunner builds, it's actually really risky. But for this one, because you get free reload spawn killing in a few kills. Hey, steel boots, I can make tactical boots. I mean, I might as well start doing that. I don't know. I need to wear these steel boots. And use my agility mod pack on my boots. And then I want to put back on the protective boots because they're better. Okay. Although, maybe I should have actually tried using the agility mod. No, I think I did try that, actually. No, I haven't. Hey, health glows! Haven't seen you in a while. Alright, what else do you got here? I know there's something. and the life-saving small med pack. Huh. Come on, you. Ah, there we are. Yay, I can run! Actually, my run is still really fast, so yeah. All the red armor, not so much. Okay, where's this lead? Containment area. Oof. I almost don't want to, just because, like, I'm kind of on a bit of a run here. And there's a revenant, and that's going to eat through my health, because that's what they do. Oh, wait, that wasn't... Is that a revenant, or is that the plasma trooper I heard? No, that's plasma trooper. There is still a revenant here. Revenants are the only thing that really hurt me, because I can't dodge them. Yeah, that's a bit of a risk. I think that's going to be just lava. Like, best case scenario, heals my armor a bit, which I don't need desperately. Worst case scenario, it fills the room with lava and then I die. Or at least take loads of damage. Oh, racing people. Remember at the beginning of this run, when it seemed like killing demons was such a challenge? And then now I can just kill them like this. Oh, hey, some kind of super dual shotgun. I mean, super shotgun. Oh, it's just the super shotgun. Oh, right, because double shotgun's a different thing. Eh, I don't really want that. What does this do? Walls explode. Eh, whatever. Oh, I see. Probably every single one of these levers is the walls explode. And thus, no cover. Actually, I'll just grab this. Did something just walk into lava? Or acid, rather? Like, or lava, because there actually is lava. That is an option. Ah, shoot. Got lucky. You got lucky with timings that you had the opening to actually hit. Ow, there's the revenant. If I can just mess with its AI a little bit more. Ow. Ugh. These are like the worst enemies for this build because, like, your stupid homing weapons. I just knew that was going to happen. Hey, thermonuclear bomb. Kind of want to hold on to it. Okay, I guess no, I haven't been virus suit packs. Oh, I don't need that many shotgun shells. Okay, let me think about this for a second. First off, is this... What is this? City of Skulls? Oh, right, containment area. Which I already said no. Small med pack. I do need that. Drop that blue armor. Okay. I mean, that's the thing about this game. Tough inventory decisions is a big component of this game. And doing well in this game. You've got to be joking. Gun Kata! They're gonna blow themselves up in a sec. I'll just let them just die. That worked beautifully. That was ideal. I love that. Except for the bloody revenants. Wow, how did I miss you? Oh, wait, this is actually perfect for me. Never mind. Revenants are still gonna be a pain in the... butt. But nowhere near as much as usual. Because normally, they're not that much in the open. Of course, they went and freed the bloody demons.
fact.
There we go. What is my move speed? 0.69, what the heck? I mean, they're getting kind of lucky. I do want 0.5, really, ideally, but it's not going to happen with this armor. But this armor is saving me so much damage that, whatever. Honestly, I'm not going to worry about it. The sheer amount of damage I've not taken because of this armor. Oh, hey, Rakatron. Wait, your melee is crap. Like, taking off maybe one point of HP. And another supercharged globe. I feel like once you get to Deimos, it's kind of hit or miss. But if you can get supercharged globe chains like this, or Invuln chains like I was getting before, and just play it smart and don't get into too much trouble, you stay alive all right. Or this can happen. This is another option. Thankfully, Gun Kata, so I don't have to worry about reloading. I can just keep shooting you and running away while kiting you because Gun Kata. Oh, I'm not allowed. Again. Yeah, there we go. Alright, that's why I love this build. Like, it's one of those builds that doesn't look great on paper, too, because it's just, oh, you reload for free when you kill. What a big whoop. Why not just get reloader and reload for free or very nearly free or very cheaply anytime? And the answer is because it just makes it something you can do without having to worry about other stuff. You can just do it for two guns, or two pistols at least, of any type, which includes things like combat pistols, which take 2 seconds to reload normally, and a second is like the base unit of time. Abyssal planes. I'll come back to those later on a later run, assuming I win this run. Like, I actually haven't won HMP yet. I've won HNTR, but not H. I've won Hey Not Too Rough, the difficulty level below this, but not Hurt Me Plenty, which is this difficulty level. And I don't really want to do a whole lot of experimenting with the special areas yet. I think Abyssal Plains is probably okay, just killing stuff, but I have my main build. Oh, red armor. I have red armor. I already have red armor. Whatever. Another one of these. That was even better. And last time I had to escape. And then abuse a barrel. That's a Mancubus. Mancubi and Revenants, they fire... I mean, Mancubi, not so much. You can dodge... As long as you're in an open area, Mancubi aren't as a big deal. Their main problem is splash damage. They don't home. They're not like Revenants. Revenants home. But still, rocket launchers and splash damage. It's like... A dodging-based build is almost entirely... Oh, never mind. That was the elemental. That's what I heard. But yeah, dodge-based build... All about managing splashes. Because so many attacks... Oh, right. I got it. So many attacks have splash damage. And if you don't manage where the splashes are coming from well... Ow. Then you end up getting damaged unnecessarily. Oh, crap. Like, here... Yeah, see what I mean? Alright, let's put back on that blue armor. Wow, that was lucky. You know what? No. Give me this. And that one can keep going. That was large health, though. I didn't have to do that. And yes, I realize Lost Souls have damage resistant bullets. It almost doesn't matter. Like, it matters slightly in that it is using up bullets that could be not used. But, meh. I need more 10 millimeter. Getting a lot of sergeants and not a lot of 10 millimeters. Okay. Shoot. Don't need as many shotgun shells. Nice to find another agility. There's a supercharged globe. More supercharged globes. That's been kind of saving my life so far. Ah, large med pack. Perfect. And a berserk pack. That would have been handy to know about, like, at the beginning of the level. Oh, well, whatever. Just grab it now, anyway. Extra speed, I think. Not that much extra speed, actually. Alright, let's just get out of here. Where's the... There's the stairs. Okay, sure, from coal, that means there is another area to get to. Hey, another berserk pack. Grab you now. I really gotta focus on dodging attacks. I get free shots when I dodge, so... It's worth a lot to actually dodge attacks. Rather than just relying on my absurd attack speed. Nope, nope, nope. Not even gonna try fighting you there. Come on, come on. You know you wanna. No, erase them. Get out of our fight. The Baron and I are having a discussion. Ow, shoot. Yeah, that works too. Having a deep discussion about geopolitical issues and you just had to interrupt. How rude. Don't you know about the obligations of nobility? Great, I'm stuck with green armor. Because you plebs wouldn't let me finish my talk. Sucks. That's a mancubus. Oh. No, I think it's dull elemental of pain. Or pain elemental. Oops. Another vulnerability globe. Well, good time as any, I guess. I was right, it is a mancubus! And it was a good thing I had the invulnerability globe, because holy crap! That's what I was talking about. Alright. Should I drop with that one? Actually, am I gonna go to the wall? Like, if I don't go to the wall, I don't really need the rocket launcher that badly. Oh, hey, it's a bridge. It's a useless bridge. I mean, it would be more useful if I could possibly get it open without causing other problems. Like lava. Because my choice for opening up the bridge is literally lava. Halls of Carnage, not sure what that is. Ah, screw it. The embarrassing packs, at least I don't take damage. Get that back. At least I don't waste armor. 136 shells. All right, back to 200 shells, plus the ammo chain. Oh wait, what's my moose? Oh, 0.6, not bad. Nice to get another agility mod, get those tactical boots. Hey, just as I say that, no, what are you doing? B. Why? All right, what do the tactical boots do? Tactical boots, just enough to keep your feet warm. Move speed plus 15. Yeah, that's... I'll swap in and out, depending on what I need. Is that homing? Nah, that's normal. Phase devices can teleport you randomly. Homing phase devices teleport you to the levels... the end, the stairs. Actually, now that I think about it, would have been kind of useful that... Well, okay, was that or an Enviro suit? Or I take damage. How did you live? Must have missed. Alright, whatever. Man, armor is really being a liability right now. And Cyber Demon is in the next level, too, so gotta be careful about that. Thank you! Yes, get red armor. I'll drop the power mod red armor. In fact, I will power mod this red armor. Seems like a good idea. Especially since Cyber Demon is all about using fire, so kind of makes sense. Anything else? Hey, another chainsaw! One could run a dual chainsaw build. You know, hypothetically. But yeah, so the Cyber Demon should be easy. Depends a lot on how it's arranged. Oh. Huh. It depends on how a lot on how the levels are arranged, because if it's arranged in an ideal fashion, then I'm able to just dodge all the shots and not take damage. Otherwise, that obviously can't happen. Thank you, I'm going to need that. 66. Darn it. Thank you. Know when they're gonna fire. Like, Cyber Demon, I know when it's gonna fire because it says that it reloads its weapon. It's very conspicuous about that. Ah, perfect. That's a relief. But yeah, it makes a point of saying that the weapon has been reloaded. No, I didn't grab any of this stuff? That was like a godsend that I actually managed to get all that ammo because of all those enemies, and I forgot to even grab it. That would have been embarrassing. Oh, I don't have enough room. Well, that's a good problem to have, I gotta say. So... yeah. Two red armors. They have the fire resistance. Some fire resistance. Can I make a fireproof red armor? No, I can't. I have no mod packs. Fireproof was TB. And neither of them are bulk modded. Alright. Here goes nothing. And this... ah, shit. Took damage. Please just shoot. The reason I want them to shoot is that I can dual reload and get back to killing. Ow, damn it! Dodge. I think I get one free shot afterwards. One, two, three. Free shot. There we go. Two, three, free shot. Shit. Severely wounded. What? Great. What the? When did it say it reloaded? Okay. What? Oh! Damn it! I guess it only tells me it's reloaded when I actually see it. I keep expecting that message. I never see it. Ah, finally. Feels so silly. Oh, I can get Eagle Eye? I prefer Intuition, though. Oh, you've gotta be kidding me! Nope. This is still bad. Yeah, I've given up on that. Let's just put that out there. I've totally given up on that particular mission. Where's the archfile? First off, blue armor to at least have something. Wait, what? No. No kidding me, the weapon's empty. Where's the other archfile? There were two of the bastards. Well, I gotta say, intuition just saved me, as did having that homing phase device. Kinda sucks I wasn't able to get 100% kills, but. Raises his arms. That armored something. It's not much, but it reduces damage. Right, I gotta prioritize dodging. That gives me free shots. Always prioritize dodging. Have any other armor? I do. Great, I might as well get upgraded before my green armor does. Or repaired, rather. Kinda sucks I wasn't able to maintain my red armor, because that was some good red armor. Alright. What's my move speed right now? 2/3 of a second. See ya. What? Oh, does it? Oh, I thought it raised its arm and went to the area it last saw me, or last was targeting. I thought the targeting was fixed. Crap. Oh. Ah! I don't know how these things work. I hate fighting rocket launcher enemies. If there's any type of enemy that does not really seem to work well, it's rocket launcher, like, just in terms of how to counterplay with them, it's rocket launcher enemies. Fine. Lava. How many of you are there? And, of course, corner shooting is the universal defensive mechanic here. Always works. Even when nothing else does. I guess it's worth noting I am in hell. I'm in hell! And I've never been happier. Alright, I don't think AB gives me anything, does it? No. AT, TB. Right. Or BP. Which I could have made and chose not to. What was the Plasteel Boots thing? Because Protective Boots is acid. Is Plasteel Boots lava? It's both. Okay. Ooh, this is really good. I might just agility mod these instead. Where's my agility mod? Here we are. Boots. So yeah, agi modded Plasteel Boots. Move speed plus 10, asteroid fire. I mean, it's not gonna be huge because it's really only if I walk on them. But yeah. Better than nothing. You know, fireproof armor, I really should have made that. That's, what is that again? That was technical and bulk. So I have bulk. I mean, fireproof red armor is always the way to go. Actually, I have a, oh yeah, bulk modded blue armor. If I get a technical mod, I should probably use it on that blue armor. How much ammo can I pick up? That's all the ammo. All right. Okay, this is bad. I am on death's door. Like, I have no med packs. What? What? Wait, why have I... Oh, it's a different one. Okay. 7 minutes to... Oh, that was a bad choice. Fireproof or speed? Wait, BP was fire. Fireproof is TB. My move speed right now. Yeah, fireproof. Cancel. T. Armor. Drop something, drop ammo, pick up a med pack. Now, just out of curiosity, remind me, how does this work again? Nanofiber armor, okay. It's just... It just does not get damaged. It also only provides me with a little bit of armor. Right. I can't remember if it's always one or if it's just half of what you had before. Oh wait, I got two godsends here. One is this. I'm not sure how much... And the other one is this. Explosion in 6 minutes. Alright, well... 1 minute is set up. Oh Bad move. Darn it, why was he using- Jimmy's in the red armor! Shit! Did not use the right armor. Yeah, as you can see, hurt me plenty. I've gotten around here and then died. I think if I had actually gone through, and I mentioned I beat Hey Not Too Rough, that was on a different build. Different computer. But yeah. So that was Doom the Roguelike. Certainly better than it was last time I played it on the channel. I mean, okay. This killed by a Revenant here at the very top, that should have been a win, because I had like 5 large med packs and I didn't use them. This, at least, was me just being like pushed to the end of my resources. Now, granted, I should have probably moved when I saw those Arachnotrons, but I was pushed to the edge of my resources. I didn't use them as well as I could have. Definitely made some early mistakes on movement and taking cover. Definitely was saved by the homing phase device, which probably would have saved me in that area too, come to think of it. But yeah, anyway, that is going to be... Wait, I was called FWOP? Huh. Oh well. Yeah, that's the most recent one. That's actually, come to think of it, is the best I've gotten on... Me plenty. I know. Hey Not Too Rough says reached level 11. That's because wrong computer. Can't merge save file, sadly. But yeah, so I hope you enjoyed that. And if you think that was cool, then you can go and play it for now, at least. I don't know when, how long it's going to stay online. And if you also want to have a better produced game that's like it, then go visit the Jupiter Hell Kickstarter and throw some money their way. Because it's on the path to succeed, but obviously that always still needs more money. And I really want to see it work. Like I said, not associated with ChaosForge, but I just really like this game. And I really want to see Jupiter Hell be a thing. Because it'll also involve dual gun or dual pistol strategies, apparently. And I love doing that. I mean, it didn't work in this case, and that kind of sucked. But it's... I just love doing that. Yeah, well, actually, no. The mistake in this one was not using my red armor. Because if I'd used the red armor, I would have taken far less damage from all the shots. And when you're dealing with something that fires multiple times like that, it would have given me much better tools to work with. Yeah, if I had remembered to switch back the armor, I would have probably survived that encounter. And also not been so close to the Azabrail. A lot of little mistakes. But that's also the hard difficulty. So, little mistakes will kill you. Especially in hell. Yeah, I almost feel like I should have just continued running for the staircases and just gone to the Spider Masterman and won that way. Would have been a win, but whatever. So I hope you enjoyed that, and that will be it for me tonight. So thanks for watching, and have a good night, everyone.